when do we need a settlement, right? So settlement can be either when parties actually want to settle a particular matter which has been either lingering for a long time, or where either party thinks that, you know, there can be a precedent which can be set against either of them, which can jeopardize their rights for the future in a trademark. So mostly when you will see settlement, see, you will see that there is a litigation involved in a settlement. So settlements generally come, you come across more of settlements when either one party is in the court and there is a threat to lose a brand, or the plaintiff, even if it has got an injunction, may feel that, you know, if it loses an injunction, then it might have to then challenge that order, get into a lot of litigation to either win it or ultimately lose the matter. Losing the matter might mean losing the brand and the enforcement strategy, which can have huge repercussions. But when we talk about settlement and then we compare it to coexistence, the terms in both can be really similar. But where the settlement starts and where a coexistence starts are two different things altogether. So let's take a scenario. If you are a plaintiff in a matter and you feel that there is somebody who is infringing your brand, you go to the court, ask for an injunction, and you take an ex parte ad interim injunction order. What do you mean by an ex parte order is that you have taken an injunction against a party which has not even entered appearance in the court. Without that party's presence, you have taken an injunction. Once you take that injunction, you will go and enforce that order against the defendant. You will serve the defendant, and then the defendant will appear, enter appearance in the court, and thereafter file the pleadings and try and argue his or her matter. Once the defendant starts arguing, the defense starts appearing in the matter, and that's when the plaintiff starts realizing already there are merits into the case, right? And there is a chance that he might lose the ex parte injunction order. This is the time where the party, plaintiff generally, would think about getting into a settlement, right? So over here we have spoken about a scenario where a plaintiff might think about a settlement. When would a defendant want a settlement? If the defendant's defense is really, really weak and he knows that the brand is important, then the defendant might think about a settlement, and he might approach the plaintiff for a settlement wherein he will try and make out a case where he will limit the scope of the trademark by entering into a settlement. There might be damages also involved over there. I'll speak about damages aspect later on. So when we speak about the defendant settlement and the plaintiff settlement, what matters is that who's arguing from the position of strength. The person in the position of strength will generally dictate the terms of the settlement and also the damages. Another via media is entering into a mediation. So generally, most of the time, in fact, when there is a matter before the court and either party has got an injunction and there are delays, a lot of the times you will see that the court generally guides for a mediation. The reason is that maybe there are ego issues involved. Maybe none of the parties want to approach the other party first for a settlement, because whoever approaches for the settlement first, right, generally he or she is showing a position of weakness. To mitigate that, the court can on its own suggest a settlement through a mediation, right? So you have the Arbitration Act, you have got the Mediation Act, right? So the mediator then tries and negotiates a settlement between both the parties. Once the mediator has made the settlement, that settlement cannot be challenged. Then it becomes that becomes the basis of the final decree in the matter, right? So this is what the settlement is.